Being French, Claude Debussy was too much the witty and worldly sophisticate to permit himself the touchingly irrational aims of a Scriabin. Debussy's ecstatic experience didn't have much to do with transcendental meditation, but rather more with the contemplation of nature, even if nature as simulated by Monet. And yet there are certain striking similarities. Scriabin's magic chord, which we heard just now in Album Leaf, is basically a euphonic as opposed to dissonant combination. And the reason for that euphony is that the first five of its six tone members belong to the same whole tone group. This last note is the only one that doesn't. And for many years, Debussy's favorite response to the prevailing post-romantic harmonic principles of German music, which was built on extensions of the common triad, was indeed the whole tone scale and chords constructed from it. He didn't use it with the persistence, with the fanaticism, really, with which Scriabin devoted himself to his magic chord, but it's there, and it's one of the factors that gives much of Debussy's music, especially pieces like the Clarinet Rhapsody, which James Campbell is going to play now, its deceptively rhapsodic and informal profile.
Thank you. Thank you.